Hey guys, what is up? Jean Entre here from myonlinebizjourney.com, and I'm coming your way this video today with the tools that you can use to build a successful blog. Okay, so let's jump right into it. So usually people are confused as to what tools they need to be using to start a blog, and the truth is that when I started blogging, I was confused also, because there are a plethora. It looks like my favorite word recently is plethora, because I find reasons to use it. Anyway, there is a number of tools that you can use to blog. You know, there's Squarespace, there's WordPress, there's Blogger, there's Typepad. There's so many tools out there that you can use to blog now, and some places even let you blog on their website. So like medium.com allows you to blog on their website. But what are the tools that set people really up for success? And you know, over the 5 years that I've done this, I'm just going to share with you tools that I've used personally that have made me successful, tools that I know other major successful bloggers use that have allowed them to be successful, but customize that to my own story and my own experience. Okay, so like I said, there's so many tools out there, right? But these tools can be broken down into three categories. Number one, you have your content creation tools. Number two, you have your lead generation tools. And number three, last but not least, and most important, since we want this to be a successful and hence profitable blog, your monetization tools, all right? So the way you can remember it is to make, you know, the acronym CLM. CLM, right? So content creation, lead generation, and monetization. And I'm gonna break it all down. Alright, so content creation is where you are going to go ahead and create, you know, the written content, the video content, the podcast. Now, I know I'm talking about blogging, so why am I talking about vlogging and podcasting? Because I do believe that it's important, even if you have a vlog or a podcast, to have a home base, to have a place that people can actually click to and find your content. Because here's the thing, you need to be able to host your own content on your own website, because those platforms where you host the content is not always going to be available. iTunes could go away, you know, there's no sign of it going away. But if you're a podcaster, iTunes could go away. If you're a vlogger, YouTube could go away. And yeah, it's true that these are huge organizations, and it's unlikely that they'll go away anytime soon. But you definitely want a home base, and that will become really apparent when it comes to lead generation. So you want to have a place where you create content. One of the platforms that has been amazing for me personally has been WordPress. All right, and there are two flavors of WordPress. There's usually WordPress.com, where you can go, you can buy a domain, and you can, you know, register a domain and whatnot. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is known as a self-hosted WordPress site. A self-hosted WordPress site. And I'm going to do a few tutorials on how to start your own self-hosted WordPress site. Super, super easy. Hosted sites, that means that you need a hosting company. So you want to go with a company like SiteGround, Bluehost, Fat Cow. I personally used the two I've used that I've loved, Fat Cow and SiteGround. When I started out with Fat Cow, I outgrew it because my traffic increased and I just had to move over to something more robust, and that was SiteGround for me. And they both treated me really, really well. If you would like links to those two, I will leave my affiliate links beneath this video. Okay, so you want WordPress hosting. The next thing you want to do once you've gotten WordPress hosting is to download WordPress. That's a whole technical procedure, but it's super, super simple. They make it super easy on most hosts these days. It's usually a one-click install of WordPress. You go ahead and you do that, and within 5 minutes you have a content management system. And that's why WordPress, really, that's what it is. WordPress and Squarespace, they're all content management systems that allow you to create content. So that is number one. Number two, you need your lead generation tools. What's lead generation? So now you're going to be putting content out there. You have to find a way to capture the information of people that are finding your content. So like this video, all right? I have a few links below this video. I tell you to go to my website. I tell you to go to my Twitter. I tell you to go to my Facebook. These are all ways for me to capture information of people that are going to watch this video, people that read my blog post. The thing with social media, however, is that once again, you don't own those platforms, okay? And so you want to collect people's email addresses. And even now, people collect people's cell phone numbers. So there's text marketing, but email marketing has long been an amazing staple of those of us that have built our businesses online. You want to collect that information so you can keep in touch with those people that sign up or find your content, okay? There's several tools for you to be able to do this. The tool that I have used, I'm using currently, is known as ActiveCampaign. It starts around $17 per month. However, if you are unable to pay that amount just yet, you can use MailChimp. MailChimp has a free account for, I think, up to 2,000 subscribers. They even have free automations. That's, you know, a fancy word, but I'll explain it later. An automation simply is, you know, when people sign up for your email list, they are delivered a freebie, okay? So you want to be, a freebie could be a PDF, it could be a video, it could be a checklist, it could be so many things. But it's important that you give people a reason, you give them an incentive to sign up for your email list. And that incentive could take on many forms. Maybe you are a beauty vlogger or beauty blogger and you tell people to go to your website. There's a form that they need to fill that out. And what are they going to get? They're going to get a checklist of 10 things every, you know, lady needs to have in their makeup bag so that they slay every day, you know. And that could be your freebie to your list. And so people sign up for that, they go into MailChimp. MailChimp captures them as a lead, and you can keep in touch with them, you know, when you have new content out, when you have things to sell, just, you know, to build relationship with them. It's a great relationship building tool, and that is lead generation. And now, for building out forms, MailChimp and ActiveCampaign both have forms that you can usually take code from MailChimp or take code from ActiveCampaign and just put that on your website. You can also create what is known as landing pages. I personally love landing pages. And one of the things, the distinguishing features of a landing page is that the only thing you can do on the website is sign up for, you know, that freebie. And so it's either they take the action you want them to take, whether it's buying something or signing up, or they click out of that page. Those are the only two, because it's been found that when you increase decision making for people, then they don't take any decision at all. So if you just make it one decision, all they have to do is sign up or click out, you know, two decisions, two very, very stark decisions, then you're likely to collect more leads. And the program I'm currently using is known as Thrive Themes. I'll also leave a link to that below this video. I love Thrive Themes. The other products like Lead Pages, Insta Pages, what are some of the other ones? I'm just trying to remember. My Lead Pages and Insta Pages come to my ClickFunnels is another one that's more on the high end. But with Thrive Themes, the reason I love it is because I paid a one-time fee, and it's, you know, you have it for life. It was $67 one time, and I have it, and I can create as many landing pages as I want from it. Of course, you can upgrade, so you can get extra features and incentives, but the plugin, it's a WordPress plugin, and it's only $67, and, you know, it's more than paid for itself, to be honest with you. And, you know, since you're trying to build a business, you have to think of it as a business. There's so many free tools out there, but you can depend on free tools for only so long. However, you don't have to also run your business expensively, and I'll make a video on that as well. Alright, so that's lead generation. You want to have a freebie that you, and you want to have a way to save those emails. That's MailChimp or ActiveCampaign. You want to have a way to collect those emails. You can get forms from ActiveCampaign or MailChimp, or you can go the landing page route using Thrive Themes or Insta Pages or Lead Pages or any of these other kinds of products, okay? All right, then last but not least, number three, and you need a monetization strategy, so monetization tools. And this is a whole subject. I believe it's a whole university subject. But basically, you want to be able to have ways to make money. I talked in this video, okay, about how you can, four ways I make money. as a blogger, and I don't know if it's going to come here or there, but I'm going to put it up in the pop-up. And I've talked about four ways I personally make money as a blogger. There's so many ways. You can start out with Google AdSense, you can have affiliate links, you can sell your own products, you can sell your services, you can sell coaching, you can sell speaking, you can sell so many things from your blog. And it just depends on you and what your goals are and what your strengths are. But I would say that when you're starting out, a good way for you to start out, an amazing way for you to start out if you don't have any products of your own, is to start out with affiliate products. Because, you know, if you're already recommending things to people, if you're already doing a really phenomenal job, of telling people, of educating people like I am now, of educating people and really helping people solve their own problems, then when you recommend something, people are like, oh yeah girl, you know, I'm gonna click through this link and purchase this thing. And you know, you can have affiliate commissions from as little as 5% to as much as 50% sometimes. And so that means that if somebody clicks through a link of mine and purchases, let's say, Thrive Themes from me for $67, and I think currently Thrive Themes affiliate level is about 50%, then that means that I've just made 32.50. And if 10 people purchase that in a month, then that's, you know, a cool $300 sitting in my account. And I didn't have to do much for it. All I needed to do was to create some content around it, promote it, tell people, hey, this is what I use, I love it, it's helped me collect leads, it's helped me make money. You know, and I really, you do a good job selling their product, then yeah, they're going to come and really give it really honest. And one of the things I want to say about affiliate marketing is don't promote things just because you're going to make money. Promote it because you use it, you love it, you know, maybe the company has paid you to promote it. But even if the company has paid you to promote it, and they give you an affiliate link, please do be careful, because you're building your brand. And if you continuously recommend bad products to people just because of the money you can make, you will make your money all right in the short term, and in the long term it's going to really, really affect you. So just pay attention to that. Affiliate marketing definitely is a great way to start out. Some people have started out monetizing using Google AdSense. However, I won't recommend using Google AdSense from the outset. Why? Because on the outset, when you don't have a lot of traffic, not a lot of people are going to see those ads, and it can make your website look cluttered if you do not place them properly. I do use Google AdSense on my website. It's not my main stream of income, but it is a stream of income. But I did put it on my website at a time when I had a lot of traffic to my website, so it kind of pays off. But when you're just having, you know, when you're starting out, it can just make your website look cluttered and unprofessional, and people are just gonna be like, eh, you know. But definitely it is a legit and amazing way for you to make money when you're starting out. You can also create your own products, so ebooks, e-courses, all these are ways for you to make money. You just have to sit down to decide which one of these things you want to do. What tools do I use? I use PayPal to collect payments sometimes. I use SendOwl. I'll leave the links in the comments. I use SendOwl to deliver my ebook. I have used Teachable to host my courses. And yeah, basically that's what I do. For consulting, you can use something like Acuity Scheduling to have people schedule. And then, you know, I think even with a paid version of Acuity Scheduling, you can have PayPal integrated into that. There's just so much that goes into this. Like I said, it has to be a college course. All right. So basically, I just gave you a foundation of what you need in order to start a successful blog. Number one, you need a content creation. You need content creation tools. You need lead generation tools. And then you need monetization tools. I just laid them out there for you. I will be following this up with a video on the different things that, you know, different, go a little bit deeper into some of these things. But just to give you a good foundation, I just gave you the three kinds of tools that you need in order to be successful as a blogger. Hi guys, so if you enjoyed this video, you know what you should do. You should go ahead and hit the subscribe button and subscribe, yo. And then once you're done subscribing, make sure to hit the thumbs up. Make sure to leave me a comment. Say hey in the comments. I do read every single comment that comes up on this channel, and I do try to respond to everybody that responds. So please leave me a comment. God bless.